So I need to get a quick update out there. This is your restriction. This actually pops out of the back of this tube. So your mass airflow sensor is going to calculate based on the diameter of the tube. When this thing's removed, the diameter of the tube changes, and you haven't told that to the ECU. Now, these are wideband O2 sensors, and they can adjust somewhat, but my suggestion would be to pull this thing out, your restriction. And this is for people in non-carb plus states. Let me reiterate that, non-carb plus states. And then slide this tube back in. This is notched, so all you have to do is pull the filter, and this will just slide back in the tube. That way your mass airflow sensor has the right diameter, and your O2 sensors can adjust accordingly and tell the ECU what's going on. Now, one of our subscribers was kind enough to share his results, and he did data logging on both with the tube and without it. I'm going to read from that. And this is verbatim, so I'm just going to read it off. The mass airflow calculates airflow based on the diameter of the tube being a fixed size. Correct. If you change the diameter of the tube, the calculation is off. And by removing the insert, you've increased the diameter too without telling the ECU. The ECU can adapt, and that's where the fuel trims come in. So his long-term fuel trim was adding 17% more fuel with the tube removed. When the tube was reinserted, it was back to 10, which is acceptable. You'll get a check engine light at 25. So 17 is a bit high. So I'm just going to show you how to reinsert that tube really quickly. If you pulled your carb trap and you want to put the tube back in, all you have to do is pull the air filter, slide the tube back in there, you're good to go. Now, if I'm pulling this air filter, I like to remove the upper lid of this air box only because it allows me to get this air filter to seal correctly. Let's take this. Let's see. I'm going to pull your air filter back off. That out of the way. Take your tube and just line up this notch with where the mass airflow sensor is. Put the air filter back on, and like I said, this is why I like to take this thing off, because it's really hard, that spongy material. Make sure my tab's down. Back in. Done. That should correct your air fuel trim, and you should be okay. And once again, the restriction's removed because the trap's out. From what I can tell, the diameter on a 2021 is the same as what it would be on a 2022 with the tube inserted. So they made this section of the 2022 wider to allow for that hydrocarbon trap to be inserted. So I know I look a little scruffy. Sorry, I want to get this information out to you as fast as possible. I want to thank John out there for this data logging that he did. It's certainly going to help. If you've pulled the entire unit, put the tube back in. You don't want to be running at 17%. You want to be under 10, and that's where he was in his long and short after putting the tube back in. Once again, this only applies to states outside the CARB and CARB plus states. This is emission controls, and you don't want to end up in any kind of hot water. So please consider subscribing. Leave comments if your information is a little bit different. If you're doing data logging on this and you find out something a little different, let me know. Thanks for watching. Until next time, we'll see you.